Hey YouTube, Sam here. Well, notice anything missing? Yep. Douchebag alert. In my opinion, people that steal this kind of stuff, I may never get vengeance, but God will. That's what I can at least know and take a little bit of comfort by, because thieves are no better than murderers, according to the Bible. So, as far as I'm concerned, you don't even want to hear my opinion on what I'm concerned about you. What's on the bottom of my shoe looks better than what you are to me. So anyways, we got to fix this. Luckily, well, if you want to call it luck, they took my tanks. I had the larger tanks like that, and I have a couple more. Unfortunately, the ones they took, my father, when he passed away, I grabbed those off of his trailer before we sold it, and now I no longer have that. Anyhow, but when they went to take the batteries out, they were too stupid to figure out how to undo four wing nuts, and started cutting through wires, and they cut through the smaller ones, but couldn't get through the larger one that I put on there in a previous video for the charger that I put in there. Anyway, because they were too stupid to do the wing nuts and tried to get it with probably what I'm assuming was a Leatherman or something like that, they didn't actually get the batteries off. So at least I still have my brand new batteries, or I'd have been way over the top upset even more than I already am. But anyhow, we're going to remedy this, and I'm going to go ahead and I haven't figured out exactly what I'm going to do. I'm either going to make or buy something that will secure my batteries and my tanks down. So I thought I would do a little preview of where we're starting right now. I'm doing this and kind of looking at it, and as I figure out what I'm going to do, I'll get back at you. One other thing to you would-be thieves out there, or thieves that are out there that are just taking this opportunity of I see it, I want it, so I'm going to grab it because insurance company will pay for it. Well, my deductible is higher than what it's going to cost me to replace these. So it's all out of my pocket, and I have no money, no extra money to be spending on this kind of stuff. So just for those that really think, oh, the insurance takes care of it, you're not harming anybody, you are. Even if the insurance does take care of it, mentally, you're harming people. So think about that if you're just a crime of opportunity kind of person. Scrap metal stuff that I think will work. Some bigger pieces of stainless that are from my dad's when he had a wood stove in his garage, and when he took that out, he gave me this stuff, and a couple other pieces that are just from scrapping, and they're actually non-magnetic stainless, so it shouldn't have any problem with any rusting at all, so at least not for a long time, and might have some corrosion issues, but rusting shouldn't be too big of a deal. So I'm thinking this is the best material that I have anyways in my possession. If I had a bunch of aluminum, I might make it out of that, but this is the next best thing. And I did have to go buy a few specialty things for cut stainless. Stainless, drilling and cutting stainless is next to impossible unless you have the right bits and cutters. Regular cutoff wheels, my dad tried to cut some of this other stuff with one of my regular cutoff wheels. It did it. But he went through several of them trying to just cut a fairly small part. So I went and grabbed this. It's a Diablo at the local home center. Metal cutoff wheel, but it actually says on here somewhere metal and stainless. So hopefully that'll last a little longer. I am going to use this one just to kind of compare them and see. I also went and got this Milwaukee cobalt drill bit. I also went and got some of this angle iron, which is aluminum. Now, I know there can be issues mixing aluminum with stainless and any other thing, any two different metals together dissimilar. You can have corrosion issues, but yet again,
I'll probably not be around when I need to worry about that. So, and if you look at this, this is actually aluminum with a stainless top, and this was actually like for the bottom, because it has aluminum and the stainless, just to kind of give it a little bit more strength. I think this is a pretty good sturdy piece here, so I'm going to use that. Now the angle iron, because I don't have anything to weld stainless or aluminum or anything with, as far as anything other than regular metal, I went ahead and got these, and what I'm going to do is actually rivet it all together. So, and I got some aluminum rivets. That is my plan. Whether or not it'll work, we will find out later on down the road. But anyhow, I'm going to start. I took measurements of what my box needs to be. Now you're going to need to figure out what your measurements need. In my trailer, if you've watched any of my past RV videos, I have 2 6-volt golf cart type batteries. So they're bigger and heavier than normal 12-volt batteries. So, I want this to be fairly sturdy and secure. So I'm going to start cutting it up. I'm not responsible if you hurt yourself doing something I do. If you don't like the way I'm doing it, don't do it. I figured out actually coming backwards with the cut is easier than trying to go forwards. This seems to want to kick back quite a bit, but actually this just kind of pulls it right through. Here seemed a little bit close to my knuckles, so I decided I'm going to try this right here. I got an actual face shield just in case we have any issues. I also have some eye protection on here. Now I'm using a different straight edge here because that other one was aluminum, and although I think I got a pretty good cut, it did nick that up a little bit. So I'm going to cut these side pieces here. I already cut one just to kind of test to see how things would work. And basically, I just lay, this is the piece we're trying to frame right here. I just lay that on there, get it butted up to the end there. Push it in tight. And I'm just going to mark it right there. This on here, right on that line, and I got the factory edge of this piece. Let's see, right? Yeah, factory edge of this piece on here. So I'm banking on that they probably can make a better cut than I can as far as being straight. And I put it right on that line because I want it right to that edge there. My battery died, so I'm not sure exactly what I got here, but anyway, I got the factory edge of this right to that mark right there, and then I'm gonna clamp it on down. To drill the bottom piece here wants to go down, so I actually grabbed a piece of wood and I'm sliding it in there. It'll still probably go down some, but hopefully that'll kind of keep it from going too far. We'll see. I might have to get a bigger piece of wood, but I'm gonna try this. Holes are too big, or my rivet gun is not exactly correct. I didn't have any sizes that would fit this, so I'm just sticking it in the end of the gun here and using it this way. And I've done this before and it's worked, but when I do that, I don't know if you can see this, it sticks up quite a ways. So what I'm doing it's getting a phone call.
Back to it.
So what I'm doing is I got my hammer and dolly here, and I'm just putting the dolly on the bottom end and hammering this down. Or whatever. This is just kind of a prototype, to be honest. But anyways, that smashes them down so they're at least decently flat. So then when I stick the battery box in, or battery in here, I think the whole battery box will fit in here, I'm hoping. I won't have any problems. What I probably will actually do in the end is stick something over this anyway, just to keep any rubbing problems from happening from those sticking up. And that's plenty strong, it'll hold it. It does kind of squish the bottom a little bit too, but like I said, this is actually, you know, already been scratched up material for the most part. I did scratch it pretty bad with those clamps, trying to clamp this
whole bottom piece done.
That should sit down in there. I've tested it out. I got plenty of room. I did figure something else out though. I'm going to put a piece across here like this. And I shouldn't have drilled these two rivets here. I should have waited to do that, but it's easy enough to pull these out. Now I did actually go get a new rivet gun at Harbor Freight, $8.99, and it actually does squish them down a little bit deeper here, but I'm still having to pound them in here because it's just not, I want it pretty. Now just kind of clamp these together with just some of these little spring clamps here. So I know that this is going to basically be the shape of my box right here, or the size of my box. I'm going to go take this to the trailer, kind of fit it in there, make sure, because I have some worries that this is going to hit up against the trailer, because the trailer kind of comes out a little ways, and I'm hoping it doesn't. Take this the way I have it and go check it out. I just turned my heat on, so if you hear a fan come on, you know that's what it is. Whether you want to call it global warming or not, it was 80 degrees 2 days ago, and now I got my heat on in my garage again. So something's wrong with the environment, regardless of what you want to call it. Beyond that, as I expected, these are too tall. So I'm going to have to kind of take a different route. This on here, that'll help me kind of line all this up. I can actually mark where I need to drill the holes in there. When I went to do this, marked it, kind of double checked it, and realized I didn't do a very good job of marking it. So what I went ahead and did, and you can't see it up here, I cut another piece like this to put up in here in between these two, and I got it set so I don't want to move it. So anyway, that way it kind of spaced the top right where I needed it and kind of helped square it up. And then I took and measured it from corner to corner, corner to corner. It's right dead on 14 inches. So I'm good. So I'm going to go ahead and mark it again here. I'm just going to take my Sharpie now that I got these all where I want them. I'm going to need some holes across here for the top, so what I did is took my upper piece here, drew a line. Now I can kind of get a measurement, hit the center, and maybe a couple more here, and then I'll know. No matter how I seem to make this, try and make this work, at the minimum size I need to get these two of these batteries in where I need to put them, it's just not going to fit in its original spot. So I'm going to have to modify the trailer a little bit. And it's been boggling me because I don't feel like I'm making this much bigger than the box that was in there. But then I realized when I started looking at that, this has an angle to it. And no matter how I build this, I don't have the equipment to make these complex bends. And the trailer just kind of goes up this way. And if I keep it like this, it's hitting the side of the trailer up here, but I really can't have it any shorter than that, or I'll be interfering with some of this stuff here and the cables and all that kind of stuff. Now my second thing that has come up is I planned on actually putting this way, putting another one on here, and having the top, which this is like similar to the size of the top that I have, if I can get my hands out anyway, have it come and go in here like this. And I was gonna have this all the way around, something like that all the way around, where the I could slide the top on and off. Well, to get these batteries in and out of here, if this was going around here all the way around like this, it would make the hole too small to be able to pull these batteries out, and I just haven't figured anything else
for a couple days after I got these on, because I was kind of having trouble figuring out how I wanted to finish this off and put the top on. Then I kind of came up with starting out with something like that, only a smaller piece, and just bending it over with my vise and squeezing it on here like this. And then I'm going to drill it and put rivets in it, and I'm going to do that all the way along this edge right here.
These side pieces on here sticking out, this is where it's going to lock down. I got these two side pieces actually right here, but they're not completely locked down. I put some rivets kind of in the holes where it's going to be to kind of line it up, and then this is the piece I'm going to bend around, I'm hoping anyway. So I'm kind of lining that up on there, and to make this look right in the corners here, I had to kind of overcut it in this area, so I'm going to have to kind of cut off a piece here just so it will bend down. Alright, now I got this on here where I think it needs to be. I've clamped it, so it's hopefully going to stay where I think it needs to be. Now I'm just going to run my Sharpie along the bottom here. I really like these Sharpies. I don't know if I've already said this, but the ones that have both dual tips, you got a fine tip and then your fat tip, and I really like those. And I'm actually gonna take it to right here, so I can't really, well, you know what, I am actually gonna mark that on the inside as well, and then I'll have kind of an idea of where I need to go. I just need to remember to cut this way, don't cut that way. Now I'm going to do that on both sides and cut that out. Okay, well, we got these corners on now, but I couldn't, because I'm putting them, overlapping them over this piece here, I can't squish them down tight to this piece here using the press. So once I get things kind of drilled out and figure out where I want everything, I'm going to have to come along with like a C-clamp probably and squeeze it the rest of the way down. So I'm going to try that. Worst case scenario, I think the rivets will hold it together pretty good and maybe even bring it together a little closer. And it's already pretty flush on the inside, and if there's a little bit on the outside, so be it. I think this looks all right the way it is. And I did have to finesse these corners a bit more with the grinder. Drilled now. I know they're where they need to be. Rivets fit into them. Now the next step is to figure out where I want the rest of the holes, and I'm just kind of eyeballing the center here. You can measure as much as you want, but I got a hole down here that I already have, and I want them to line up, so I figure if I do that, that should be the center of the hole. I'll have to figure out where the center of this is later and put an X marks a spot, and I'm just going to go along. I got this drilled out. I'm just going to go along, and I got rivets in here, so I know it's where I want it to be. I put rivets in these, but they fell out when I was knocking on this a little bit. But I can see that most of them are lined up. I'm going to probably have to do some drilling because some of them just didn't line up. But regardless, we're going to go ahead and mark this one here. I'm not exactly sure where I left off, but I believe I had one more side to go. Put it on, same as the other one. Only I actually did find that I actually had some rivets that in most of the spots worked out well. They don't stick out as far, and they were the same size. I thought that they were a smaller diameter, but actually it turned out they were the same size. So definitely needed to use smaller rivets, and it would have been a lot easier. I wouldn't have had to pound things down, although they still stick out a little ways, so, but I don't think they'll be a problem. Anyhow, so we got the box together. Now it's time to do the lid. We're getting close, YouTube. Got the top. I've started cutting everything out. Now, if you want to build it while I'm building it, basically I decided that, gonna find the piece. On each side, I'm going to want these here. And I've cut these like this. Kind of go underneath there and it'll make a decent corner, I'm hoping. And then I'm going to just rivet the whole thing all the way around, just like I've been doing. Basically, I'm building another box, only it's only an inch deep. And I decided to do the corners a little bit different here. And as you can see, yet again, we got the lip here on the box. This is going to go on just basically just sit on there just like that. And then you got this piece kind of over the edge. And then I'm just going to drill like a hole and put a lock in it. That's basically my plan, I believe. For now, anyway. I can always change my ideas later. Something that's kind of neat, if this is all put together, it'll give me a nice handle on each side that I can lift up on, which is kind of a side benefit for that. So, anyhow, so I'm just marking it out, drilling it, and doing the same thing I was doing with drilled it out like this. This is for the other side, and marked it. And I'm just going to do it one piece at a time, because then I'll know that this goes on the other side, of course, exactly here. And I'll rivet that in. Then I'll take and I'll probably put the pieces back on, do the other side, and then do the sides. Yet again, you can do it however you want. I'm going to go drill it out. Well, I got it all put together here. I am concerned about these rivets sticking up a little bit, messing with things. So what I did is I got this Eternabond. I used my trailer here, and I actually cut a chunk of this down to size, cut it in half, and I'm just folding it up and sticking it in the corners. I'll in all the corners, just kind of a taped kind of, just keep the batteries or and whatever from being scuffed up on these sticking out here. They're not really sharp corners or anything like that, but they do stick up a little bit, and some of them probably have a few sharp corners. So this is just kind of a protection. I'm not really trying to waterproof or anything. I did end up covering up my mounting holes, which are probably going to wind up differently anyway. So I still have the drain holes down here because, like I said, it's not going to be a waterproof box. If you're looking for a waterproof box, I doubt this is going to be very waterproof. It should be water resistant, I would say, but waterproof, no.
Well, here it is such as it is. I still got to do some cleanup and stuff on it. I will say it definitely didn't turn out the way I planned from the beginning. It is just kind of a box with a lid on it. And that's where I'm going to keep it for now. At some point I may try and figure out a different type of top so that I can hinge it up. But actually in the trailer where it is, if I go to hinge it up, it'll end up hitting on the trailer up here further. So the best thing for this right now is to be able to pick it up and pull it off. And then I can get to my batteries. I can do whatever I want while it's in the trailer. I can work on the tops of the batteries here still. And I can put it down. Now I am going to drill some holes and put some lock system on it of some sort. I haven't quite figured that out yet, and I still have yet to mount it in my trailer. Like I said, it's not going to mount where I planned on mounting it, so I am going to have to do some modifications to my trailer. I am going to have a video on that, but this video is already probably longer. I'm fairly happy with it. I had to put an X here and an X here because if I go to turn this around, it does fit, but it's kind of tight on this edge over here. It's not perfect. Like I said, it's probably about a little over an eighth inch off square one way or the other. So that did make the top a little more difficult to build as well. I don't know if it'll be in the video or not, but I mentioned actually, you know, cutting these out here. I think in the end it actually looks better just to leave them overlapped. So if I was to do this again, I would just overlap them. It was so much easier, and I don't think it doesn't look bad, but it doesn't look any better either. So it didn't really help the looks, and it was a lot harder to do. So anyhow, there she is
here. So hopefully you can hear everything. Here it is on the trailer. We've got the mount right there with little pool noodles on the end there to kind of tell people they're there. Like I said, I know that doesn't look great, but I do have plans in the future to upgrade this to where I have more batteries, and I think this will work pretty good. I am a little worried about the tongue weight, but I'll deal with that later. Right now, batteries are in it. They're all hooked up. Everything's working good. And the kind of cool thing, see, I was trying to put it down on that mount right there. Here comes a wash truck, so it's going to get loud. I'm going to shut it off. All right, it went by for the most part. Anyway, that's the old mount down there where you can see the bracket sticking up, going across here, and you can see a little bit of it down in there. That's where I was trying to put it, but as you can see, it's fairly close here, and if I bring it further down and further back, it was hitting on here, so I wound up making my own mount and putting it up here. Anyhow, so the box is up here. It's sort of finished, admittedly. I'm not done sanding on it and stuff like that. I'm heading out of town this weekend, so I've got to get this done and in, and I'm going to test it out, see how it works. And then if I like it, like I said, later on I'm going to do some upgrades. I'll finish it off then. So she's all hooked up. Now I'll show you how I am holding the batteries down inside there, because I had a lot of trouble trying to figure out battery mounts. I don't know if you know what this is. Actually found this on the side of the road, and what it is, it's one of those Harbor Freight floor mat things. And basically I took that, cut it up into shape. I got a couple more pieces here, and I'll show you how I'm going to hook that down. I got a couple extra pieces here that I just put right on top of these battery right here, and I'm taking this, sticking it right on top of that, kind of cut it to size. Now I know it's not pretty, but it's actually working better than I hoped. I should mention also, I've stuffed some down in between the batteries here so that I don't have any movement there as well, side to side. I forgot to mention that, so that's something you definitely want to do if you're building anything similar to this. Okay, got that on there. Stuff the top on. Okay, and that holds it really tight. And then I went and got a set of these, and that's how with the truck again. That's how I'm locking it down. And I just have one kind of kitty corner, opposite corners of each other, kind of towards the middle. Now you'll notice this little hole here. Well, the problem I was having is this will fly up and bounce around and stuff in the wind. So I found these are wall anchors. Got one of those in there. And I do the same thing on the other side. Now I got that in there, and that just threads in there. And I stuff that up underneath here, that holds it. And since I have power here, I mean, I can use a screwdriver or whatever I have on hand, but that will hold it down nice and tight. So anyhow, I got one of those on both sides, also Kenny corner. I just got it the opposite of where the lock is here. Hopefully you saw, can see that, but anyway, it does stick down a little bit. I might actually cut that off at some point and make it look a little nicer. But that holds that down really good and tight. It also, you can feel the little bit of a bulge, not a lot. It's not a ton of pressure, but it sits down on top of the battery, so those batteries shouldn't move at all in there. That's one of those things, if you do something I do and something happens, I'm not responsible. If you don't like the way I'm doing it, don't do it. Anyhow, I think this is pretty well done for now. I will probably have some updates as I use it more and tell you how I like it. I also will have a video coming out that is going to talk about things that either I messed up on or I would have done differently or will do differently when I build another box. So keep an eye out for that video. Should be coming out fairly soon because I kind of filmed them at the same time because there were several little things here and there where I just wasn't quite happy with it. But all in all, it's going to do the job, and I think it looks all right. All right, this is Sam, Jack of all, master none. You all have a good one.